This man receiveth sinners. Luke chapter 15, verses 1 through 10. COL equals Christ Object Lessons by Ellen G. White. Luke chapter 15, verses 1 through 3. Then all the tax collectors and sinners drew near to him to hear him. And the Pharisees and scribes complained, saying, This man receives sinners and eats with them. So he spoke this parable to them, saying, Let's look at verse 1. It says, Then all the tax collectors and sinners drew near to him to hear him. The accusation made by the rabbis insinuated that Christ liked to associate with the sinful and vile and was insensible to their wickedness. That's in Christ Object Lessons, page 185. Then the phrase, drew near to him, which refers to the fact that Jesus was attracting a certain crowd. The people who were drawn to Jesus were all the publicans and sinners, which refers to the tax collectors and those who were considered to be the worst of sinners in Jewish society at the time. These individuals were not well regarded by the religious leaders and were often cast out and looked down upon. Yet, despite their low social standing, they were the ones who were drawn to Jesus, eager to hear his words. The symbolism in this verse is rich and meaningful. The act of sinners and tax collectors drawing near to Jesus symbolizes the longing for acceptance and redemption. It also symbolizes the inclusive nature of Jesus' ministry, where everyone is invited to come and hear his teachings. The fact that Jesus willingly engaged with these individuals represents his compassion and desire for all to come to repentance. Let's look again at verse 2. It says, And the Pharisees and scribes complained, saying, This man receives sinners and eats with them. This verse takes place during a gathering where Jesus is spending time with tax collectors and sinners. The Pharisees and scribes, who were the religious leaders and scholars, were critical of Jesus for associating with such individuals. In their minds, someone who claimed to be a teacher sent by God should not be mingling with those who were known sinners. In Christ Object Lessons on page 185, Ellen White asks this question, Why did he go about so unpretendingly working with all classes? The act of eating with sinners symbolizes Jesus' desire to have a relationship with those who are lost and in need of a Savior. In Jewish culture, sharing a meal with someone was a sign of acceptance and fellowship. By eating with sinners, Jesus was showing that he was not afraid to associate with those who were considered unclean or unworthy. The souls who came to Jesus felt in his presence that even for them there was escape from the pit of sin. Christ Object Lesson, page 186. The murmurings of the Pharisees and scribes symbolizes their self-righteousness and lack of understanding of God's true nature. Instead of rejoicing at the fact that sinners were being reached and saved, they chose to murmur and complain, exposing the hardnesses of their hearts. Ellen White asked this question on page 186, Christ Object Lessons. The scribes and Pharisees felt only condemnation in that pure presence. How was it then that publicans and sinners were drawn to Jesus? Luke chapter 15, verse 3. So he spoke this parable to them, saying, you know, Luke 15:3 serves as the introduction to the powerful and timeless parable of the lost sheep, which conveys profound themes of God's unconditional love and the joy of repentance and of the call to actively seek out the lost. Christ did not at this time remind his hearers of the words of Scripture. He appealed to the witness of their own experience. Luke chapter 15, verses 3 through 7, the parable of the lost sheep. So he told them this parable. What man of you, having 100 sheep, if he lose one of them, doth not leave the 99 in the wilderness, and go after that which is lost, until he find it? And when he hath found it, he layeth it on his shoulders, rejoicing. And when he cometh home, he calleth together his friends and neighbors, saying unto them, rejoice with me, for I have found my sheep which was lost. I say unto you, that likewise joy shall be in heaven over one sinner that repenteth more than over the 99 just persons which need no repentance. The parable of the lost sheep highlights several important themes. Firstly, it emphasizes the value and worth of each individual. The souls whom you despise, Jesus said, are the property of God. Christ Object Lesson, page 187. The shepherd's willingness to leave the 99 in search of the one lost sheep speaks to the value that God places on every person. No one is beyond God's care and concern. He is willing to go to great lengths to seek out those who are lost. Secondly, the parable underscores the concept of repentance and redemption. The joy that is experienced upon finding the lost sheep mirrors the joy in heaven over a sinner who repents. This serves as a powerful reminder of the forgiveness and grace that God extends to those who turn to Him in repentance. The imagery in the parable also holds deep symbolism. The shepherd is often seen as a representation of Jesus, who seeks out the lost and rejoices upon their return. Christ likens himself to a shepherd. I am the good shepherd, he declares. The good shepherd giveth his life for the sheep. I am the good shepherd, and know my sheep, and am known of mine. As the Father knoweth me, even so I know the Father, and I lay down my life for the sheep. John chapter 10, verses 11, 14, and 15. The sheep symbolize humanity in need of redemption, while the wilderness represents the struggle and challenges of life. The sheep that has strayed from the fold is the most helpless of all creatures. So, with the soul that has wandered away from God, he is helpless as the lost sheep. And unless divine love had come to his rescue, he could never find his way to God. Christ Object Lesson, page 187. The act of laying the lost sheep on the shepherd's shoulders reflects the care and responsibility that Jesus takes upon himself for the redemption of humanity. The parable of the lost sheep serves as a powerful message of hope and redemption. It challenges the attitudes of the Pharisees and scribes, emphasizing God's relentless pursuit of those who are lost. It also serves as an encouragement to sinners and outcasts, reminding them of the immeasurable love and grace that God offers to all who turn to him in repentance. Overall, the parable of the lost sheep is a profound illustration of God's love, grace, and redemption. It emphasizes the value of each individual, the joy of repentance, and the relentless pursuit of the lost by the Good Shepherd. It continues to serve as a timeless and powerful message of hope and salvation for all who are willing to turn to God in repentance. By the lost sheep, Christ represents not only the individual sinner, but the one world that has apostatized and has been ruined by sin. This world is but an atom in the vast dominions over which God presides. Yet this little fallen world, the one lost sheep, is more precious in his sight than are the 99 that went not astray from the fold. Christ Object Lessons, page 190. Luke chapter 15, verses 8 through 10. The parable of the lost coin. Or what woman, having 10 silver coins, if she loses one coin, does not light a lamp, sweep the house, and search carefully until she finds it? And when she hath found it, she calls her friends and neighbors together, saying, "Rejoice with me, for I have found the piece which I lost." Likewise, I say to you, there is joy in the presence of the angels of God over one sinner who repents. The parable of the lost coin carries several important themes and messages, all of which provide valuable insights for believers. The primary theme of this parable is the concept of God's relentless pursuit of those who are lost. The lost sheep knows that it is lost. The lost coin represents those who are lost in trespasses and sins, but have no sense of their condition. Just as the woman in the parable tirelessly searches for her lost coin, God diligently seeks after those who have strayed from Him. This conveys the unwavering love and grace of God, as well as His desire for all to be reconciled to Him. The imagery of the woman lighting a candle and sweeping her house to find the lost coin also holds symbolic significance. The lighting of the candle represents illumination and the search for truth, while the act of sweeping signifies the careful and thorough efforts made to find what was lost. This illustrates the idea that God's pursuit of the lost is intentional, deliberate, and meticulous. It also emphasizes the importance of actively seeking God and His truth in our lives. In this work, all the angels of heaven are ready to cooperate. All the resources of heaven are at the command of those who are seeking to save the lost. Christ Object Lesson, page 197. In a broader historical and cultural context, this parable would have been particularly meaningful to the audience of Jesus' time. In the first century Jewish society, a woman's 10 silver coins would have had significant value, as they were often part of her dowry and held great sentimental worth. The urgency and determination with which the woman searched for her lost coin would have resonated deeply with the audience, emphasizing the importance of each individual's relationship with God. In conclusion, Luke 15 verses 8 through 10, as the parable of the lost coin, conveys powerful themes of God's relentless pursuit of the lost, the value He places on every individual, and the responsibility of believers to actively engage in the mission of seeking and saving the lost. Wherever we may be, there the lost piece of silver awaits our search. Are we seeking for it? Day by day we meet with those who take no interest in religious things. We talk with them. We visit among them. Do we show an interest in their spiritual welfare? Do we present Christ to them as the sin-pardoning Savior? With our own hearts warm with the love of Christ, do we tell them about that love? If we do not, how shall we meet these souls lost, eternally lost, when with them we stand before the throne of God? Christ Object Lesson, page 196. The vivid imagery and symbolic elements of the parable serve to reinforce these themes and provide valuable insights for believers across all generations. This timeless parable continues to inspire and challenge Christians to actively participate in the work of reconciliation and redemption, and to appreciate the immeasurable love and grace of God. In terms of symbolism, Luke 15:10 conveys the idea of the heavenly realm rejoicing over the repentance of a sinner. The angels of God represent the spiritual realm, and their joy reflects the joy of God Himself. This symbolism reinforces the idea that repentance has cosmic significance and is a cause for celebration, not only on earth, but also in heaven. It also underscores the notion that the salvation of individual souls is of most importance to God and His heavenly host. When one is brought back to God, all heaven is made glad. Seraphim and cherubim touch their golden harps and sing praises to God and the Lamb for their mercy and loving kindness to the children of men. Christ Object Lessons, page 197. Ultimately, Luke chapter 15, verses 1 through 10, points to the profound and transformative power of repentance and redemption in the eyes of God. Thank you, and God bless you.